Recall that our original purpose was to find a transformation of the formula such that a truth assignment satisfied the original, if and only if it could be extended to the transformed formula. And we've seen how to do this transformation for a single clause. But actually, this is enough. We can just transform each clause individually, introducing a new set of variables for each. All the same arguments about extending or restricting the truth assignment will hold. Let's illustrate what a transformation of a multi-clause formula looks like with an example. Consider this formula here, where I've indexed the literal z with two indices now. The first referring to the clause it's in, and the second being its enumeration within the clause. The first clause has only two literals, so we transform it into these two clauses with three literals by introducing a new variable y11. It gets the first one because it was generated by the first clause. We transform the second clause with five literals into these three clauses, introducing two new variables, y21 and y22. Note that these are different from the variables used in the clauses generated by the first original clause. Since all these sets of variables are disjoint, we can assign them independently of each other and apply all the same arguments as we did to individual clauses. That's how CNF can be reduced to 3CNF. And of course, this transformation runs in polynomial time, making the reduction polynomial.
We just reduced the problem of finding a satisfying assignment to a general CNF formula to the problem of finding a satisfying assignment to a 3CNF formula. At this point, it's natural to ask, can we go any further? Can we reduce this problem to a 2CNF? Well, no, not unless p is equal to np. There is a polynomial time algorithm for finding a satisfying assignment to a 2CNF formula based on finding strongly connected components in a graph. Therefore, if we could reduce 3CNF to 2CNF, then p would be equal to np. So 3CNF is as simple as the satisfiability question gets, and it admits some very clean and easy to visualize reductions that allow us to show that other problems are NP-complete. We'll go over two of these. First, the reduction to independent set, or clique, and then to subset sum.